Joining me now, Representative Marsha Blackburn. Representative, welcome to the show. Another chaotic day in the world of the GOP in this race for the nomination. First, I want to go back to Paul Ryan. You spoke highly of him. He's sort of caught in this awkward place where a lot of Republicans find themselves, being accused of being the establishment on one side, but also being wooed as a potential savior on the other side.
Well, I tell you, Paul is doing a good job moving forward legislation in the House. And quite frankly, Charles, I think what he's trying to do is say, look, leave me alone. Let me do my job. I don't want to be president. I'm not running for president. I wouldn't do it if you ask me. What I am going to be is the most productive Speaker of the House. Now, I think Paul Ryan's being really smart about this. He's a smart guy, and politically he's being very smart and astute. He's saying, let me accomplish something. Don't undermine me. And you know what, all this talk about, oh, he's going to be a nominee, that undermines his ability to get legislation across the finish line in the House. That is his goal, and I think he's doing the right thing.
Ironically, though, he sounded presidential. he lobbed out a few things that perhaps he would like to see with respect to the tone of this race. And a lot of people believe because he did make this statement today, he is more or less saying there will be a contested convention, and I want to be the referee of it.
Well, I think that Paul is developing that presidential persona, but it's for a race where he can stand on his own 4 or 8 years from now. I don't see this as being today. Now, laying out the case for a contested convention. Now, I'm going to give you another prediction, Charles. I was the first one to tell you it's an outsider year and Trump or Cruz will be the nominee. They'll be the last two standing. That's where we find ourselves today. And I think that these guys are going to work this out before we get to the convention. I think you're going to see some deal making, some coming together, delegates moving. And some of the establishment just needs to take a chill pill. This is not an establishment year. It is an outsider year. The American people want an outsider nominee. And that outsider nominee, whomever he may be, is somebody who is going to go beat Hillary Clinton. And I'm going to work tirelessly for that nominee and to make certain that they become president of the United States.
Then what do you make of Kasich talking about the tone, fear and anger? Certainly, you cannot dispute that that's been a hallmark of this entire process, and it seems to get worse on a daily basis.
Well, there is a lot of the rhetoric, and I would love to see the rhetoric toned down a bit, too. Many people would. But the good thing is people are more engaged than ever, and they're going to show up to vote because they're fed up with what's gone on in Washington, D.C. They have a right. I mean, this is their money.
Right.
It's their freedom. It's their country. Thank goodness they care enough to fight back. Now, I would encourage Mr. Kasich to remember that this process is something where the American people are speaking their piece. He likes to talk about having been a part of this process as a member of Congress and as a governor. Yes. He has done those things, but you know what? They're kind of frustrated with him, too. They're frustrated with people like me that have been in elective office. They want somebody who has not been there as a part of the establishment in Washington, and God bless them. They're showing up to make it happen.
So then, having said that, is the nomination process with the caucuses, with the delegate gathering, is the nomination process fair to these people who are showing up?
I think that each state has its nomination process, and it behooves candidates to fully understand that and have that ground game. You have to have that grassroots ground game for those volunteers to get them to those places of participation, whether it is your state executive committee selecting nominees or whatever. Now, I do think that the integrity of the process is being challenged because people are watching how some of this delegate selection takes place, and they're seeing people who did not run for delegate inserted into the process, and people are going, hey, wait a minute. If you want to be a delegate, put your name on the ballot and run. But hey, state parties, don't go inserting people that haven't participated in the process. So, you know, kind of a fair warning to all there to guard these processes very carefully.